Hello everyone, and welcome to part 4 of CSS Level 1. We won't actually be doing any coding for this lecture. Instead, we will just be getting a tour of the Google Chrome Browser Inspector, which is a really useful tool for us to actually explore the HTML, CSS, and even later on JavaScript on a website. So go ahead and open up Google Chrome and let's start exploring. Okay, so here I am at Google Chrome. And I have the part3.html file from last time, which is linked to the part3 CSS, open up in my browser, and then in another tab, I have the Google Home website. What I want you to do is with the part3.html file open, you can right click, and previously we've seen how we can just view page source, and that shows us just the HTML that's linked to this document. But what I want to do now is instead of just viewing the page source, which is just the HTML, I can right click on this and click on inspect. And now let me zoom in a little bit. I can see that here on this panel, I have the HTML code. So that's what we've seen before and stuff gets highlighted as I select it. So as I select H3, I can see that H3 over here is highlighted. And you can also see that there's almost like a bit of a border around it. Some parts blue, some parts orange. We're going to be discussing that later on. But what I really want to focus on here is the styles since we're talking about CSS. So we can bring this tab over. And here I can actually see the styles that I was assigning to that CSS. So second div is a class where the color is red. And what's really cool about this is you can actually click on some of these things and edit them. So if you begin to zoom out so we can see the whole thing, click on color red and you can actually change this color in real time. So if you want it to be blue, you can see right here on the second div, it's actually changing. So we can make it something extreme. And we can just make it any color of the rainbow we want. Great, and other things we can do is select an element to inspect it. So for instance here on NPR, we can see now that it's an LIA, and we can see that border and color. So again, we can change the color, or we can even change other properties in real time. So if I want to make this border super thick, you can see that I'm changing it in real time as I type this. Or if I want to make it dotted instead of solid, I can do that as well. All right. So there's two reasons why I want to show you this. One reason is that if you're working on a website, you can immediately just load it up, start inspecting it, and quickly change things on the fly so you can see how things look and change them immediately without having to constantly refresh your website. You can just play around with the colors here live instead of constantly refreshing. But the more useful tool on this is actually exploring other websites. So for example, you come here to this Google homepage, and if you're interested in how something works or what font is going on, maybe you right click, inspect, and you can click on this little tool, which is select an element in the page to inspect it. So we click here on the Google search button, and now we can see the various styles that have to do with it. So you can see it has a color. We can change that color if we want. So we see here we're changing the font of the actual Google search. Maybe we change to something green or blue, etc. Something to note here is the only thing I'm changing is what I'm seeing in my browser. If I refresh this page, I'm not actually changing any of the files or any of the CSS files. But again, you can play around with this, maybe make the font huge, so Google search, etc. And as we approach JavaScript and learn how to work with the DOM, which we haven't talked about yet, but we will in the future, we'll see how we can actually use JavaScript to grab some of these elements and then affect them. But right now, I just want you to be aware of the Chrome Browser Inspector as a really great tool for you, not just to explore your own websites, but other people's websites as well. Okay, that's really it for this lecture. Thanks everyone, and I'll see you at the next lecture where we'll hop back into CSS and start coding again. 5 of CSS Level 1. In this lecture, we'll briefly cover a CSS topic known as specificity. Specificity defines the hierarchy of CSS styling and what type of tags overrule others. We've actually already briefly seen this when we were using the asterisk tag, and we saw how even though we use the asterisk tag in an attempt to cover all the tags in an HTML document, tags that had an ID call on them were able to maintain their styling. We're going to cover the hierarchy of this in this lecture. Let's get started by jumping straight to the Atom text editor. All right, here I have the Part 5 HTML document open, and I have a heading for specificity, but what I'm going to do is add in an unordered list, and each list item is going to have a particular tag with it. So this first list item is going to belong to a class. And we'll call this class top items. And we'll give it the name, or we'll call it just first. And then the second list is going to say an ID. And that ID will be 2, but it will also belong to the class top items. We'll say it's the second. And then finally, we'll have third, and then another list item called fourth. So let's save that, refresh over here, zoom in a bit, and we see we have the first, second, third, and fourth item in this list. The first one has only the class, the second one has an ID and a class, and then the last two, third and fourth, are just normal list items. Let's see what happens as we begin to add in styling. Let's say we just style everything that has li to it, and we say, okay, the color of all list items are going to be red. If I refresh this page, all list items become red. But now, let's say I also grab the top items class. So remember, with a class, we have to use that period or dot. And I call color here. And I color it blue. What do we think is going to happen here? Well, if I refresh, I notice now anything with the class top items has become blue. So top items is higher in the hierarchy than a general tag call. And that kind of makes sense. You would want general tag calls to happen after you have a class. And then further up the hierarchy on top of a class is an actual ID. And remember, we do IDs with a hashtag. So right now I have the ID of 2. And I'm going to specify this to have a border. And we'll give it a 3-pixel border that's solid black. Save this, refresh this page, and now I can see that on top of not just the normal tag or the class tag, ID has superseded that. Just as a general note, throughout this course, we actually won't deal with the issue of specificity too often because we're going to be using more formatted CSS, focusing on other things, or just using Bootstrap. We won't run into this issue too often, but it's something you should be aware of in case you find yourself one day working with CSS and you're unsure why some effects aren't taking place. Maybe you're accidentally overwriting something due to its specificity. In the part5_master.css file, that comes with the download for this course, you'll notice that there are two links, and I'm going to expand this right now and talk about them. The first link is the Mozilla Developer Network page on specificity. It talks about the concept. It actually talks about how it's calculated, where specificity is actually a weight that's applied to a given CSS declaration, and it talks a little more about it. Another one, that the other link is here, it's called Design Shack, and it just talks about what the heck is CSS specificity. And I actually like this link a lot because it just talks about tags versus tags. So what wins in class versus class? What wins in ID versus class? What wins in a pseudo class versus a pseudo element, etc., and the different levels of specificity. Again, not something that we're going to be running into a whole lot throughout this course, but it is something you should be aware of. Okay. That's really all that I wanted to talk about for this lecture, just the fact that specificity exists, and probably the main ones you're going to be running into is ID superseding class, superseding a general tag call. Okay, thanks everyone, and I'll see you at the next lecture where we begin explaining your assessment for this section of the course.